Star Wars Squadrons was announced last week in a weird tip of the hand that happened between Xbox accidentally leaking some stuff and EA forcing themselves to reveal some stuff. Anyways, let's talk about Star Wars Squadrons and what we know, what we don't know, and what we gotta hope for in the future. First of all, this is a squadron-based game, as the title suggests. We're talking about squads of fighters, of ships, being used to do giant battles in multiplayer and some single player as well. And this is going to be set after the Battle of Endor. Also, the whole game can be played in VR, which honestly, if you have it, that's probably the place to play it because some of the visuals look a little weird. The screen's a little busy with all of the aspects of the fighter pilot cockpit. And that is very immersive if you're in VR. I think it's great that they've added that, but it's going to feel a little weird and a little static when you're playing that in regular, but just know that's what they're going for. They're going for immersion on this. This is focused on multiplayer, but there will be a single player campaign. Single player is going to be both Rebels and Imperials. I'm assuming this is going to be similar to how Battlefront 2 was, where you go between the two and telling a story, and they introduce you to not only the ships, but the concepts as you move through and progress through the story. That's my guess. They have the ships defined by category, which I think is great to allow for balance because this is a very big multiplayer focused game, so we need balance in that. You have fighters, which are kind of all around ships. That's your TIE fighter and X-Wing. Interceptor class, which are more for high maneuverability. Those are TIE interceptors and A-Wing. Makes perfect sense to me. A-Wing is really agile. You have support, which are going to help. They mentioned in regards to supplies and other tactical support aspects, that's going to be your TIE Reaper and the U-Wing. And then we have bombers, which are obviously a TIE bomber and a Y-Wing. Interestingly enough, B-Wing's not on this list. I would assume that B-Wings were going to be in there, but I think they needed to fit this into the mold of for balance purposes, not necessarily full on lore and a Star Wars story, but more of what ship can we use that will fill this purpose in the game, and making sure that you have ones that match up from Imperial and Rebels that align. That's what it's all about. Multiplayer modes that we have here are going to be Dogfight, which is 5v5, and then you have Fleet Battles. And the Fleet Battles are going to be multi-stage conflicts with your squadron. Again, everything's all about squadrons and team play. You're going to have three phases in the Fleet Battles. The first phase is going to be a standard Dogfight. I'm assuming whoever wins that moves to the next phase. They weren't really clear on how the ball gets moved left to right here. But phase two being attack or defend two medium capital ships. And then the final phase is to disable and destroy an opponent's large capital ship. We're talking about the large Star Destroyers, probably the Super Star Destroyers as well. And there will probably be different, not only maps, but different ships and environments that you can go in to these. Otherwise, it'll be a little boring, but either way, I think it'll be fun. EA also promised everything here could be earned through gameplay, meaning all your unlockables, which they showed a lot of cool unlockables, a lot of customizations, and they said it could be earned through gameplay, earned solely through gameplay. I really hope that means there aren't any microtransactions whatsoever or loot boxes. I would like to just earn all of this through sheer gameplay. If I put in the time, give me little bonuses here and there. And if I get better at the game and I finish these challenges, hit these trophies, then give me the larger, the harder to get collectibles or what have you. I mean, we saw everything from like an Ewok bobblehead to suit customization, tie customization. Yeah, I think there's a lot of really cool things here that they could do. I just want it to be all through gameplay if possible. Tying this all together, pun intended, this game is going to be $40. That's not bad. It's going to be released on all platforms at $40 and in VR, as we mentioned, and that's October 2nd. So it's coming up really quick, and $40 is a really good price point because I believe this game is more multiplayer focused, and if you have a game that's more multiplayer focused, you don't need to price the game at $60. They've said time and time again, single player is what costs us more money to make. Well then, give us multiplayer games for cheaper. Great example right here. On to what we don't know. They didn't talk about seasons. They didn't talk about events. I'd like to know a little bit about that, how they keep the community going in this game. I'd like to know more about that. And I'd like to know, like I said, seasons and also I'd like to know more about DLC plans. I know that's weird because usually people are saying, well, give me the game, then talk DLC. But in this environment of 2020, they usually expect that there's going to be some type of DLC involved. And we expect it, they expect it, everyone expects it. So just tell me what you're thinking about in the future. Give me an idea of what we're moving towards after the game is released. Is this something that I'm only going to play for 2 months? Or is it something that you're going to foster a player base with? On to what I'd like to see in this game. Starting off, I'd like to see some historical battles. This may end up being stuff that they add through seasons or DLC. I'd like to see historical battles of Death Star runs, Death Star 1 and 2. I'd like to see some stuff centered around Hoth. I mean, obviously, OG Star Wars is the best Star Wars, so I want to see that. Additionally, I'd like to see, and this could all be DLC, but I'd like to see some stuff centered around the Clone Wars, center some stuff around the sequels. So basically you have prequel trilogy, original trilogy, and sequel trilogy all together. Now, obviously there will be problems where they won't mix and match in regards to sequels and prequels and all that. That's fine. But I would like to see some scenarios that you could drop into. Maybe specifically saying, hey, I'm matchmaking. Okay, I want to do prequel events, slot me there, and go do Battle of Mustafar or whatever. Mustafar, what am I talking about? There's no ships in Mustafar. What's wrong with me? Give me some ships over Coruscant and all that. Like, that would be really cool. Give me Jakku. Give me all that separate from original trilogy and all that separate from sequels. It'd be really fun, and I'd pay 10, 15 bucks per DLC to unlock these scenarios and ships, because then you can bring in the Jedi fighters in for the prequels, and you could bring in the whatever the sequel stuff was for the Rebels. I don't remember what they were called, but you can bring in the really cool ships and continue to bring people back to your game. Anyways, let us know what you thought about Star Wars Squadrons. Was there anything you'd like to see in there that they didn't talk about, or something that I didn't mention? Let us know in the comments, and we'll see you next time.